Good morning, everyone. I'm here today to talk a little bit about a smarter way to build the Internet of Everything. And the story today is about the Internet of Things. Conventional wisdom tells us that the Internet of Things is typically conceived of as a machine-to-machine paradigm. But I would like to challenge that and let you think about it in a different way. And I just want to say that the teleprompter is not working, so I'm going to have to do this extemporaneously. And so I'll have to ask you to move to the next slide, please. Less than 1% of the objects in the world today are connected. So instead of thinking of mobile phones as the endpoints of this machine-to-machine paradigm, instead, think of them as vital gateways to connect unconnected things to the Internet of Things. So if we go to the next slide, please. This object here is really what allows you to treat the mobile phone as a gateway to billions, even potentially trillions of objects in the world today. And Cisco and IBM tell us that there'll be anywhere between 50 billion and 1 trillion connected objects by the year 2020. But here I would like to pause. Let's really examine the economics, the scale necessary to not only connect these devices to those currently unconnected objects, but also the economics and scale required to manufacture them. It's not only about connecting, it's how are we going to make 100 billion, 200 billion or more systems that are both smart and connected just 5 years from now. Consider for a moment just one component of this plan, the semiconductor chips that are needed to power these systems. Gartner tells us that in the entire semiconductor industry that has been built up over 40 years, we have the manufacturing capacity to make about 30 billion chips a year. And that can grow, but it is constrained to grow no more than about 10% per year. And if you consider that connected devices typically have more than one chip in them, then it's impossible to conceive how within 5 years we will even approach 50 billion, let alone the 1 trillion that some of these industry leaders are predicting. As a consequence, that means that in sum, today's semiconductor industry can only deliver 1/10 of what is needed to connect ordinary objects, fast-moving consumer goods, disposables, to deliver a little bit of intelligence to hundreds of billions of connected smart objects, to populate the world, objects that can sense, store, and communicate data. A fundamental paradigm shift is needed. A paradigm shift, then, both in how we manufacture and how we design in a little bit of intelligence to these currently unconnected things. Now, Thinfilm, the company that I lead and that is originally based in Scandinavia, we have our headquarters in Oslo and R&D in Linköping, Sweden, where we have created technologies that allow us to print electronics. Our approaches are highly scalable and require capital investments that are orders of magnitude lower than conventional electronics. Here you can see, for example, a printing press that can produce 200 million memories or 100 million displays per year in just one printing press. And take a look at that roll on the left. It is about as wide as a 16-inch wafer, but it is 1 to 1.6. kilometers long. Think about that batch size. Think about the number of devices that can be printed on something like that. So we use innovative materials, advanced printing processes, but we make simple electronic systems. And that means that they're at a cost point, at a level of complexity that is appropriate to integrate on a wide range of ordinary, currently unconnected products. So, how do we do this? Thinfilm's NFC smart labels show one how one can take packaged goods, everyday things, and make them smart and connect them through a mobile phone, or connect them through a tablet or other edge of the network device. Let's take a look at some examples. Here is an NFC temperature sensor. With it, you can sense, store, and communicate whether perishables, things such as produce, meat, pharmaceuticals, have been kept at the correct temperature throughout the entire logistics and distribution chain. Imagine a few use cases. Imagine if you're a doctor in a rural village and you're tapping your smartphone to see whether a vaccine was transported properly. Or imagine a chef in Tokyo that can see that the sashimi that he will be serving tonight was stored safely from the time that the raw material, the fish, was caught. All with the tap of a smartphone. But equally importantly, as we are tapping at the chain of control of the entire logistics chain, the distributor of the vaccine also knows it arrived safely. The fisherman who caught the tuna knows it was received fresh, and because at the time it was tapped by the chef, he also pushed an accept button for the delivery of the product after checking the temperature, then the restaurant can be invoiced immediately. So, to me, this illustrates a very important point. Many of the things that we've heard about the Internet of Things are about big data, about consolidating and analyzing information in the cloud. But there's an important distinction between this small data that I'm talking about and big data. Small data is the data we need to make decisions now. Do we administer the vaccine? Do we accept the delivery? The data is in your hand, immediate and actionable. In contrast, big data is about aggregation, taking millions of data points to see patterns, either in that supply chain or in consumer preferences and behaviors. So then the question is, how do we get to that true potential of Internet of Things for the mobile industry? We need to make it dynamic. We need to make it pervasive. We need to somehow link that small data that is actionable to the big data in the cloud that allows us to do analysis. Now, with the smartphone not as the end or the edge alone, but as a gateway, we can do this. Because now with NFC, we can use our smartphones as being a gateway in this process. So last week, we announced a partnership with Diageo. And in this partnership, we're taking one of their premier brands, Johnnie Walker Blue Label, and we're adding just a little bit of intelligence to this particular product. With Thinfilm's OpenSense technology, you can detect whether the bottle is sealed or whether it's been opened. And now I would like to show you a little video on how this allows you to contextualize information about the consumer, contextualize whether the person is in a buying situation or in a consumption situation, and allows you, including location services that we've heard before, to be able to understand the context in which the user, through the use of NFC, is actively deciding that they want to extract information from the product. So here, let me share with you this vision through this video.
What if a bottle could communicate with you, providing valuable information, when, where, and how you wanted it? Thinfilm and Diageo have joined forces to reinvent the role a bottle plays in the consumer experience, transforming the iconic Johnnie Walker Blue Label into a prototype smart bottle that speaks to consumers in an entirely new way. With Thinfilm's revolutionary OpenSense technology, this unique bottle wirelessly talks with a user's smartphone, instantly delivering custom content while providing an added layer of authenticity protection. These patent-pending sensor tags detect whether a bottle's seal is intact or opened, while, unlike today's technologies, remaining readable even after the factory seal has been broken. As a result, the technology empowers Diageo to extend the dialogue and enhance the relationship it has with its consumers. With a touch of an NFC smartphone, each bottle's unique identity triggers real-time marketing experiences and supply chain analytics managed by the Everything IoT Smart Products Cloud platform. Through OpenSense, each bottle of Johnny Walker Blue Label becomes an interactive medium capable of delivering timely and targeted digital content from the cloud. Whether engaging in-store shoppers with promotional offers and relevant information, serving cocktail recipes to consumers at home, assisting retail employees on the shop floor, or streamlining the supply chain, all with a simple, effortless tap of an NFC-enabled smartphone. Diageo and Thinfilm, transforming bottles for a new digital generation and setting the bar for technology innovation in the drinks industry.
So thank you. This is just an example of what one can do when one adds a little bit of intelligence to fast-moving consumer goods products. Thinfilm's collaboration with Diageo provides a compelling example of how working in partnership, printed electronics enables consumer engagement based on simple item-level intelligence that can be deployed on a scale of billions and trillions. Printed electronics is the only technology that has the scalability to extend the Internet of Things, typically machine-to-machine communication, to the Internet of Everything, where we finally connect those 99% of ordinary objects that are not yet connected today. But Thinfilm is not alone. We are already partnering with companies such as Diageo, with Xerox, with Symmetric, with Flextronics, as well as global leaders in retailing, in packaging, security, pharmaceuticals, and food monitoring, which have already put their stakes in the ground to start this process of using NFC to extend the Internet of Things to the Internet of Everything. Tapping is fast becoming the natural way for consumers to exchange information with the physical world without the broadcast intrusiveness of beacons. One is opting in not once and then hoping that they receive the right messages. No, one is deciding. The consumer is, in fact, in charge and decides when it's useful to extract information from physical objects. In making buying decisions, in completing payments, in extracting information they want and need. Expect that soon we will find it natural to explore the digital experience made possible by these smart objects that are just a little bit intelligent. Welcome to a world that is becoming a little bit more magical, a little bit more personal. Thank you very much. Thanks, Drew.